So that's it. Summer 2022 officially done. What an absolute disgusting statement to say. Now, despite being away for pretty much most of it, I couldn't leave you guys without an August 2022 blog income update report. Thingy-majig that we're gonna call it. You'd think after about a year or so on YouTube, your vocabulary would get better, but nah, not happening. So let's dive into the page views and the earnings for my blogs for last month, as well as what some of the goals are gonna be forward in September. Let's jump into it. The earnings. So last month, August 2022, both my blogs brought in a grand total of $249.78. This is down from July's $342.88, so around about $100 or so. That being said, I'm not too worried about there being such a large discrepancy between the earnings month on month. First of all, and we'll dive into this in a little bit more detail when we go into the individual statistics for the blogs, but my sites weren't actually impacted too bad by the Google helpful content update, which they've decided to roll out this month. Secondly, the earnings for last month were a little bit artificially high on the back of Amazon increasing the percentage of commission you were earning, I think for Prime Day or whatever it was that they were doing last month, which is why there's such a big increase. So let's dive into the individual sites and see how they're performing, starting, of course, with the one, the only, the pretty terrible site number one. So site one is the first website I ever created back around 2 years ago now. It's got 116 posts on it. They haven't been updated in well over a year, and it just kind of lies there looking at me, wishing I would update content. But guess what? Until you earn your keep, you ain't getting touched, mate. Last month then, this website brought in a grand total of 4,704 page views, which is actually up on the month before's 4,362 page views. In terms of monetization, as many of you know, this site is already monetized through Ezoic and through Amazon Associates. Last month then, it brought in $39.25 from Ezoic, $61.13 from Amazon, for a grand total, why did I say that twice? Of $100.38. Now this is down quite significantly from the $206 or so from the month before. But again, site one has the most amount of affiliate links on it, so it's natural that this would take the brunt of the major discrepancy there between numbers. Believe it or not, Ezoic earnings on this site are actually up around about $7 or so. So it's actually increasing the Ezoic earnings. It's just the Amazon ones that have taken a bit of a hit. Next month, I'm just gonna continue to leave this site and let it do its thing, and hopefully hope for this site to earn between those 4,000 to 7,000 page views, which it's been bouncing around over the past couple of months or so. Site two. As many of you are familiar with now, site two is basically where most of my focus goes. Whenever I think about, you know, starting a new side hustle, starting a new blog, any of those kinds of things, this site definitely keeps me grounded. So in terms of the general goals I had for this site for last month, I wanted it to hit that $150 per month mark, hit 16,000 page views, and get 5 brand new posts on the website. So how do we do? Now, sadly, your boy didn't manage to hit any of these goals. However, it came pretty close to a lot of them. So kind of excruciating, man, I'll be honest with you. In terms of page views, the goal was 16,000, but we managed to hit 14,658 page views, which is up around 18% from the month before's 12,413. Literally, just a tiny bit shy of the 16,000 page view per month mark, but pretty sure that next month we'll be able to do it, hopefully. In terms of earnings, last month this website brought in a grand total of $149.40, so an excruciating 60 cents away from that $150 mark, but we'll get there. We'll get there. Be better. Now, in terms of content, I was aiming for 5 additional pieces of content, but after being super jet lagged, I had to take a couple of additional days off, and that just meant that I only managed to get 4 brand new posts on the website, so still very, very happy with that. Site 2 then now has 125 total posts on it that are around 15 months old in total. So how is this website performing against Income School's Project 24 timeline, which is basically the course that I follow? Definitely recommend investing in it if you are a beginner and new to the world of blogging. There's an affiliate link in the description box down below. Well, according to their timelines, in month 15, the website should be earning 16,000 page views, so just a little bit short of that. I'm bringing in quite a ridiculous $600, if I'm being perfectly honest with you, but seeing as this website hasn't really been monetized through affiliates, through info products, it doesn't even have an email list or anything like that, I can kind of understand why I'm leaving some money on the table. I think one of the big learnings about Site 2 over the past couple of months or so has been that it isn't unfortunately going to be one of those websites where one month it's earning 10,000 page views per month and then it's going to absolutely skyrocket to 40,000 page views and then keep on doubling traffic or any of those kinds of things. It is going to be a case study whereby it's a case of maybe growing 10%, 20% every single month, growing by 2,000 or 3,000 page views every single month, and just taking that slow and steady approach. Whilst that's not the most exciting thing I'm sure for a lot of you guys to be watching, it's the truth of the matter of what most people's websites probably do look like. So hopefully we can bounce some ideas off each other and see if there's anything we can do to get these numbers up. On top of this, the fact that this website managed to grow by around about 20% while we are right in the middle of a Google algorithm update just shows that my content is actually, you know, quite useful, quite good and quite helpful there as well. So definite relief, because that would be horrible. And I know unfortunately a lot of people have unfortunately been hit by this update. Goals for next month. Right, so the goals for next month, and excuse me if they sound a tiny little bit familiar, but they're gonna be the ones which I basically set up for last month. So I'm gonna aim for finally hitting that 16,000 page view per month mark, hitting that $150 per month mark, and also I'm gonna aim for 5 brand new pieces of content on the website as opposed to my regular 7, just because this month is gonna be a little bit hectic outside of work and blogging and side hustles and all those kinds of things there as well. Now if we rewind, I don't know why I'm doing that, that's meant to be spooling, no one uses cassettes anymore, but I set myself some smaller goals to help out with the page authority of the website, and I'm glad to report that on the back of gaining a couple of links to the website, I've managed to increase the domain authority from 6 to 9, which is fantastic. Now I also use Tortoise Cashflow's keyword research service to branch out some of the other niches on the website, which I'll be sure to keep you posted on the actual service and how that actually looked like, and look out for a review of that basically over the next couple of weeks or so. Now in terms of smaller goals for this month, I'm also going to try and bump up that domain authority by 1 additional point, try and get it to around about 10 or so in Moz's own scoring system, if that even accounts for anything, and then hopefully just try and increase those page views and all those other things, as well as working on battle shipping and getting that process ready for December or January when I do eventually start that. But until the next one, guys, wishing you the best of luck with your blogs. I tell you what, let's stand up and make it more interesting. Here we go. Until next week's video, guys, wishing you the best of luck with your blogs. Hopefully you haven't been hit too hard by this Google algorithm update. And until the next one, I'll leave you to it. As always, if you're interested in more videos around blogging, personal development, side hustles, any of those fantastic things, absolutely smash the like and subscribe button, as it really, really does help out the channel. And all the best. I'll leave you to it. Bye.